Hello, and today we are with Mr. John Edwards, who is the executive chef at the Orchard Wellness and Health Resort in Malaka, Malaysia. Good afternoon to you, Mr. Edwards. Chef Edwards. Is it Chef Edwards or Chef John?
Oh, Chef John's what most people call me, so let's stick with that.
Chef John. Now, how did you get into cooking? Because it's a hard job to have, and you've been doing it for many years now. How did you first get into cooking?
Yeah, I have. Look, it was purely by accident. All my friends were doing it. So it was much a case of that, and I'm probably the only one still doing it now. So, I've always loved it. Always had a love for food. Always had a love for cooking. Always been very interested in it. And that passion is still there, which is fantastic.
How would you describe the cuisine that you're cooking today? What is it that you cook?
Well, coming to the Orchard, we're trying to turn people on to good, healthy food that is tasty. We're trying to dispel that myth that eating healthy and doing what's right for your body doesn't have to be boring. It doesn't have to be monotonous. It can be sexy, it can be fun, it can be tasty, and it's something you can eat every day. So you don't have to get bored with the lifestyle.
Right. Now, you've worked with numerous chefs, some of the top chefs in the world, and in numerous different countries around the world as well. Which chefs and areas where you have worked have influenced you the most?
Well, look, I have to say that my first chef was probably the most important influence. He was a great support. He was a great role model. I got a lot of encouragement from him. He gave me the free rein to experiment, which was amazing. That said, I was on my day off, I was always in the kitchen experimenting, and he gave me free rein to order whatever I wanted and really experiment and develop skills.
Well, what's this chef's name?
Matthew Wilson was his name.
And where is he based? Is he back home in New Zealand?
He was back home in New Zealand, in New Plymouth. So, yeah, he was my first executive chef. And, I suppose a lot of the passion was really driven by him. Yeah, and he helped nurture that, which is very important, especially for a young chef. So.
Since then, you have gone on to work in different countries as well.
Yes.
Which of those countries and regions and other chefs possibly have also influenced you in to get you to where you are today?
Look, Asia plays a massive part in that. Before I came to Asia, I moved to Australia. I was in Australia for close to 10 years. Fantastic produce, fantastic food, such a high quality of food, such a high skill level. Most Australian chefs make a sort of pilgrimage to Europe and do a stint in Europe and spend many years over there and come back, and they bring all those skills with them. And the produce and the farming in Australia is probably some of the best in the world today. The animal husbandry is fantastic. So it really is a privileged place to work, Australia. Everything you have is at your fingertips, very easy to get. And it's a pleasure. So,
this is the second time you've worked in Malacca.
Yeah.
It's unusual, really, for some chefs to come back to the same place twice, especially one so young. What has brought you back to Malacca? What has influenced you to bring you back here rather than go somewhere else?
Well, look, I developed a deep appreciation for Malacca and the such a rich culture and heritage. The food history here is incredible. I think this is the place where I've found the most loyalty for food and little shops. It's incredible. You will drive past and see people queuing all day just to go in one little shop. They've got to be doing something right. So for me, it's really about exploring those roots, celebrating those roots, and really learning all I can while I'm here.
What are some of your favourite dishes? For those who haven't yet been to Malacca or are still yet to visit, what would you recommend trying for their first time?
Well, I love Nonya Laksa. It's fantastic. Chili garum fish, beautiful. If you can get it done properly by a Baba Nonya, fantastic. One of the best dishes I've eaten.
What are your thoughts on popular cooking methods such as foams? And there are new chefs as well now that are using technology which is more traditionally seen as in scientific labs than in the kitchen. What are your thoughts on such cooking?
Honestly, I think it's interesting. I think it has a small place. I think we need not forget why we eat. It's because we're hungry and because we need to sustain ourselves. I think the foam is fun, the molecular gastronomy. It's fun, it's interesting. More importantly, I think it teaches chefs to think outside the box and experiment with different products. The wonderful thing about molecular gastronomy is nearly all of the products are completely natural and derived from seaweed and things like that, which are very, very good for you. We're just applying different methods to them now. As far as my cooking goes, I don't use a lot of it. I tend to stick more to traditional foundation cooking methods. So my background is traditionally French and Italian, and I'm mixing the Asian into that now as well. So that's where most of my influence comes from.
Another common trend at the moment is wine pairing. With regards to this, how important is it to get the right wine with each course? And what tips would you recommend for people that possibly don't know wine and haven't got the palate possibly that you have?
Well, look, wine pairing is fantastic, and half the fun is getting there. It's the journey. You will often start with one or two base ingredients, and you will choose that against the wine, and it really is an evolution. It's a fantastic journey, and if you're doing it with a wine expert, there's so much I can teach you about your palate and really discovering your palate. And I think that's what it's about for food as well, is discovering and identifying what you're tasting and where you're tasting it. For novices, you've got to go with what tastes right. You just have to go with what tastes right. Explore the food in your mouth, move it around in your mouth, take it slowly.
Here at the, today of course, as we mentioned, you're the executive chef of the Orchard Wellness and Health Resort in Malaka. What type of cuisine are you offering here?
What we're offering here is a healthy balance, something sustainable for people that they can eat every day. Here at the Orchard, we're trying to help people to make a lifestyle change. This is not just a three-day program where they come in, they eat healthy and exercise for 3 days and have treatments. That's not what it's about. It's about making a change, one that's consistent, one that's positive, but also it can be one that's very interesting and satisfying as well. If you look at food and what's in food, you'll see that everything that we need in life, everything we need for our bodies, is contained within foods. So if we eat right, if we eat healthy, everything we need is there. We just need to do it consistently.
A lot of people's perceptions of healthy food could be that of boring, possibly, uninteresting, not certain. It doesn't quite reach the mark.
Yeah.
Well, could you give us a few examples of some of the cuisine that you do here for those that are on such programs?
We take healthy ingredients, and I guess what we do is we bridge that gap between being healthy and taking it to a 5-star fine dining level. So that's where our challenge lies. So we have a lot of fun in doing that. So we take base ingredients, healthy ingredients, we cook them well, and we turn it into something very creative and something a little bit interesting. We want to show people that it doesn't have to be the same bowl of healthy, boring food every day. We want to display it beautifully on the plate. If we have an ingredient, we want to do minimal to it. If we don't have to cook it, we won't cook it. We want to keep the ingredients as close to their natural state as possible.
Now, of course, this resort also offers not just the spa treatments, but they also venture into the medical. For some people staying here, there will be guests that possibly aren't part of this program.
Yeah.
Maybe the husband or the wife is just your regular Joe or your regular Jill, if possibly.
Yeah.
In that aspect, what sort of food can they have? Do they have to eat healthy as well, or do you have a full menu available?
At the end of the day, we are a 5-star resort, so we offer everything and anything. So if someone wants to have Wagyu and fries, we do Wagyu and fries. Okay, so at the end of the day, we're still a 5-star hotel. We still provide that service.
The property has over 180 acres. A lot of that is devoted to fruits, vegetables, and livestock as well. How much of the vegetables and fruit that you actually grow here at the resort is used in the kitchens, and how do you see that developing?
At the moment, is around 70% of our vegetable produce is grown and utilised here. We have around 6 to 8 large greenhouses. We plant all our own fruit and veggies so that we can have them organic. We have complete control over the growing process, the chemicals are used, which we don't use, and also when we pick them. So we can pick nice baby vegetables anytime we want. It gives us complete control over what we're doing. Also, it gives us confidence that we're using a quality product.
Of course, when you have so many acres, and the resort is limited to just around 50 rooms, I believe, in that aspect, you're going to be growing in excess. Do you sell the excess vegetables and fruits that you have out to outside guests or to the markets and this, that, the other?
Not at the moment. We want to keep this solely and exclusively for the Orchard, so that we can always provide our guests with what they need.
In France, of course, very famous for its wine and what have you. Yeah. Grapes are a fundamental part of the business. Mm-hmm. And there they have spas which are devoted to grapes. You have grape therapists. They do everything imaginable with grapes.
Yeah.
Have you been able to incorporate the fruits into the spa treatments here at the resort?
We do. In some of the spa menus, we incorporate a lot of the fruits. Yeah, we do. We are still planting also some different things and experimenting with some different things, but we try and incorporate the orchard as a whole into everything that we do, being whether it be the spa, the medical, the food, everything. It's all about the orchard and a sustainable growing process.
Sometimes it's not just about the product, it's also about the way that it's cooked.
Yes.
Do you also teach and educate the guests that are staying here to show them how to continue
Certainly.
Once they've left?
Certainly, absolutely we do. That's part of what we're doing here. It's part of the education process with people. So we run cooking classes here. We want to teach them how they can do what we're doing at home, okay? Because it's no good coming for 3 days and thinking, okay, I can never do that. The idea is to educate them and show them some different methods as well. Not only that, but we go through the whole vegetable selection process. So we'll take them through the greenhouse, we'll show them what is ripe, what's not ripe, how to pick it, when to pick it, how to clean it, how to prepare it. So we're dispelling a lot of those myths. We're taking a lot of those things that can possibly be put in the too hard basket. We want to take that away and give people no excuse not to eat healthy.
Now, finally, John, the last question for you would be, if you had the opportunity to work with any three chefs in the world for 1 month each, okay, which three would they be?
Thomas Keller from the French Laundry, Fran Adria from El Belay, and third one, that's difficult.
You're keeping your options open, I can tell.
Yeah, let's say that might be safe. Probably Damien Cook. I believe he's in Hong Kong at the moment. So.
Excellent. Well, Chef John, I have to say in that case, thank you very much indeed for your time
today.
And of course, I wish you and the Orchard Wellness Health and Health Resort here in Malacca the best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much.